malnutrition is not a topic of the past. You heard about it before. For us, we see it as a very acute situation.
You have hundreds and hundreds of millions of kids who are definitely malnourished with respect to minerals, vitamins, and so on. We have them all. It's about 500 million that we talk about. The real number is not known. In the first 1,000 days, that's where really nutrition impacts the future of all our life.
On one hand, we still need further creative solutions to reduce salt, sugar, and fat. It sounds very boring, but scientifically it can be very challenging. And there are still things to crack. It's not just that we work with replacers. That's the boring thing and the easy thing. But the more efficient, the more effectful thing is to ensure that the nutrients we have in the products are really having the maximum impact.
As a company like Bühler, we have to really look at the entire value chain as well. We believe it's a good solution to add nutrients at the end, but first we need to make sure that we maximize what we can get from the field. There's always a balance between taking out anti-nutrients, contaminants, while so keeping the food safety, while maximizing nutrition and still achieving the sensory profile that our consumers are looking for. Atta flour, that's an extremely interesting solution of a whole wheat flour that is used for an Indian type of flatbread, where we have found an industrial solution that combines the good of whole grain with the sensory properties that the consumers are looking for. We have now further developed this in our combi mill to make sure we can also cover other types of flatbread globally.
I was interested in talking about the new protein, sources. I participated in a breakout for insects and algae. Myself, as a producer, we are thinking about investing in aquaculture, and algae was one of the issues or one of the products we want to invest in.
There is a protein gap. If the world population grows as expected, we need an additional 265 million tons of protein by 2050. So we need to find new solutions. In the short term, we believe that pulses are an excellent source of protein that we can use. But in the longer term, we need new crops as well that are not in competition for arable land. So this is where we focus on processing of insects and algae.
It was a great surprise for me to know that the insect is coming out. It's in the pipeline to come out. Bühler has a pilot plant in China. We need to find protein sources to be able to solve the problems of our clients and our feed business.
There is something we can really do to contribute to nourish the growing world population. We can do it together with you. So it takes all the actors along the value chain.